Is diet soda just as effective as the wonderful water for weight loss? According to a new study, the answer is yes. But first, there is a very, very important thing you need to know before you ditch the old reliable H2O for its sexier, artificially sweeter counterpart. So let's check it out. In this new 2023 randomized control trial, bolstering a relatively high 493 participants, the researchers again wanted to see how diet beverages stack up against plain old water in terms of weight loss. These participants, categorized as overweight or obese, were randomly assigned to one of two groups where for 12 weeks drank at least 2 daily servings of either artificially sweetened beverages or only water. Additionally, they were provided weekly meetings and weight management programs and had their beverages directly delivered to their doorstep. And as alluded earlier, the 12-week results show that diet soda indeed performs similarly to water, resulting in an average weight loss of 5.8 kilograms compared to the 5.6 kilograms with only water. Other secondary measures like fat mass, hunger ratings, and sugar consumption were also reduced with no significant differences between groups. In other words, diet soda, water, both great for weight loss. But wait, there's actually more. Thing is, this new study is only part one of a larger 3-part trial known as the Switch Trial. And the second part has also been published, and it details an additional 40 weeks of maintenance along with the initial 12-week weight loss phase. That means a total intervention period of 52 weeks, a whole year of subjects drinking either diet beverages or only water. And after those 52 weeks, subjects drinking diet beverages not only maintained their weight throughout the maintenance phase, they actually lost a tad more. In total, they lost an average of 7.5 kilograms, whereas water resulted in an average loss of 6.1 kilograms. A small but statistically significant difference showing that even long-term diet soda consumption seems fine for weight management. Pair that with the overall robustness of the study, large sample size, strong statistical power, long study duration, and so on, it then probably makes you wonder, Mr. Picture Fat, this research sounds amazing. What can possibly be so important to make us question it? On the surface, barring some rather mundane limitations, mostly due to pandemic-related restrictions, this study does seem pretty amazing. Except for one major, major problem. Many authors of this research declared multiple conflicts of interest related to sweetener-supporting entities like Project Sweet and the International Sweeteners Association. And perhaps the most egregious of all, this study was directly funded by the American Beverage Association, a lobbying group directly tied to beverage companies like Coca-Cola. With such clear conflicts that would benefit from painting diet beverages in a positive light, how much can we actually trust about this otherwise well-designed research? And the unfortunate truth is that nutrition research in general is riddled with conflicts of interest just like this. Fortunately, we do have some limited, neutrally funded studies, like in 2012, that also found diet beverages performing similarly to water in terms of weight management. Other neutral research also shows significant weight improvements when directly replacing sugary beverages with its diet counterpart. However, what we don't see much is randomized controlled data on long-term weight loss effect like we did in this new Switch trial, which unfortunately, in my opinion, is by far the most impactful finding. So the ultimate question is, should we throw away the Switch trial completely? Well, it depends on who you ask, but I'm personally willing to give the researchers the benefit of the doubt when they say that they weren't influenced by their funding sources, but I wouldn't blame you if you didn't. The best thing we can hope for is to see this new data replicated by a future neutral party. Maybe then the data will be reinforced, or we can feel more confident in rejecting it. Finally, if there is one thing you take away from all of this, is that for weight loss, the most important thing is to first stop or severely limit your consumption of those high-calorie, sugar-filled beverages. And whether you replace them with a diet variety or just water is really up to you. For me, I'll stick with water and tea, with the occasional truly sexiest drink of all, a Mexican horchata. No sugar added, of course. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a sweet thumbs up and share it with your sugar-loving friends. Subscribe for more and let me know what you think in the comments. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to get your protein with water.